Welcome back. It's third period action from Jacobson Arena. If you're joining us live, it's Hockey Night in Concord for you. If you're joining us later, it's 7-3 St. Paul's for all of us. Make it 8! It's Cooper Flinton, second in the hockey game. And it's St. Paul's' turn to score early in the period. Wow. Well, it's been that kind of game. New Hampton led 3-0, and it's been a blitz by the Big Red. They scored 5 in the second. Josh Halliday has 2. Cooper Flinton now has 2. So it's 7-3, or 8-3 now. And the Big Red lead by 5. It's been one of the most wild hockey games that I personally have ever been a part of. Here's Jack Hepp at the line. For those of you joining us live right now, I've had a lot of technical issues. My computer is going to die, so it will likely die at some point here in this third period. I apologize. New Hampton has a stream. You can go watch that. I recommend you go watch that. At this point, it's probably a better quality. Anyways, nice little move there by Jake Sullivan. So, a tough response for New Hampton, though. They were all fired up at the end of the second period to get back in the hockey game. They took a timeout after the 7th St. Paul's goal, and they've come out here in the third and allowed an 8th, which they can't really do much about. 2 stops by Cal Welch there. 3 stops by Cal Welch, and 3 dandies at that. Puck is bouncing in neutral territory. Here come the Big Red again. It's Stadheim across the line. The game of momentum swings. I mentioned that, but it's been all St. Paul's, really. At 5-on-5, and 2 of New Hampton's goals were on the power play, and once we got to 5-on-5 play, indeed it was all St. Paul's. 8 goals, all of them at 5-on-5. As the Big Red offense has showed up, the defense has locked it down since the third, too, although they've had a rather, I should say, more easy job, considering the fact that the play hasn't really been in the defensive zone very much. Back out at center, here's Christian Yee. It's knocked down there. Chance for New Hampton coming in is Brandon, but he missed the net wide. And now Sam Seibold, who has a goal to his name in this hockey game, sends a long shot in. Brian is just going to snare it and hold on. Face off to the right of Lucas Brine. The shots after the second were 29-27 overall St. Paul's. St. Paul's outshot New Hampton 19-10 in that period. The shot to the front of the net was stopped by Welch. The rebound was there, and Cal fended it away. He's got a total, I wouldn't say catastrophe, but it was a mess in his crease afterwards. But the St. Paul's netminder standing strong and cool as the puck went out of the zone. It's been the zone now again. Mike Stoddard, who had a scare in the second period, took a hit to the knee, but he's back on the ice and playing all right. At center ice here is Zach Good. They're moving into the zone now. Ronnie Paragolo with the face-off circle, turned aside there by Welch. 15 minutes to play in the period, and St. Paul's leads by 5. Doherty at the line. He scored his first career goal. The freshman wearing number 24, all the way out at center fort. St. Paul seems content right now just to sit back on their 8-3 lead. I'll get you all their goal scorers at some point. Hold on a moment, here's Bryce Terry. Terry takes a look, and it was stopped by Brian. Yeah, 2-on-1 there with Grady, who takes a tumble to the ice. The other way comes New Hampton. Here comes David Halliday looking around Jack Kepp, who goes down on the ice to block the pass. Now it's centered in front. Man, the stick was lifted in the middle. Lobdell, he's got it behind the goal, takes a check from Hepp. It comes over to the near side. Nick Towns into the line. That puck bounced, and great stop by Welch. That puck bounced like a bouncy ball. Almost right up over the crossbar. Another one to the front of the goal. This one misses wide. New Hampton beginning to pour it on just a bit, so trying to get back in this hockey game. And Cal Welch makes another save. It's been all about the score sheet so far, but Cal Welch making a story for himself. Firing pass, or hot pass, I should say, goes off the boards, turned back by the Huskies rather quickly. It's more into the middle. There's a shot, just goes high. Townsend couldn't find the front of the net with it, and Cox gets it up to the line and out. Lost in a pair of skates. Tired St. Paul's players are out there right now, so Terry will take it deep. Tried the stick move, instead it just goes behind the net, takes a hit from Nowitzki. Nice little move there by Trevor Castino. The Green are out, and they're through. Schonlund, nothing doing. Here's Owen Sweet for Josh Halliday, looking for his first career hat trick, maybe. In only his third regular season game. And it's floated to the front end. Flinton's pass just missed him here. Sullivan leans in. It went off the heel of his stick. And now the other way. Oh, no. There's a third player down, and this time it's Owen Sweet. Very gingerly getting to his feet. They might be winning, but the amount of St. Paul's players that have gone on off the ice nursing something. We had Nick Frechette, and then Stoddard. And now it's Owen Sweet. It's something behind the play that I didn't see. You know, I'm impartial, I'm partial. I'm a St. Paul's student, and, you know, the guy who works for this team. Now, I don't want to see the St. Paul's players down, so I pick up on that rather quickly. They also have two major contributors out of the lineup tonight in Colin Richard and JT Halliday. Welch keeps this puck moving. It's at the line, but held in there. Tossed towards the front of the net. Puck is loose. Stopped by Cal Welch. The puck's in behind him, but the net, again, off its moorings. A New Hampton player ends up in the goal. The puck does not. Computer's at 3% right now, for those of you watching the live stream. So with 12 minutes and 30 seconds left, I don't foresee us making it to the end of the game, and I apologize. There's really nothing I can do about it. I tried charging it, it just didn't charge. Stopped here by Cal Welch. These two teams will play again tomorrow. 5 o'clock start for that one. And this is true. If you're wondering about the whole technical difficulty, as I explained in the first broadcast, I'm a one-man show. I'm the producer, the announcer, the videographer, and really, I'm just worried about the game film. That's my primary job. So as long as the game film's okay, that's what I care about. Great shot block there by Doherty. Still taking them for the team, and they're up 5 goals. Gotta love that. It's into the glove here of Brine. So, you'll have to forgive me. Well, that's what I'm saying, and this is going to happen, and the live stream's not my top priority, so even though I dedicated a lot of time on air apologizing to you all about it, because I do feel bad. I try to present the best product I can, and I realize when the last five minutes of the game, or however long it will be, or they're cut out, that's not very professional. Puck to the front here after the shot by Hep. Trickled through. Doherty couldn't get a stick on it. At the line here, Bryson Russell for Jack Hep again, right point. Went just underneath his stick. Back behind the goal. A check in there by Nathan Nowitzki. Puck's in the near corner. New Hampton will dig it free, but it comes free for Jack Hep. Stopped on the wall by Parragolo. The puck was bouncing around at the hash marks. Biggs had a hit. Hep kept it in. Parragolo stole it back, and he'll start the rush looking at Bryson Russell now. Here's Russell. Well, the shot actually just came through. Welch making two saves, three. The puck bouncing around in there. That's what looks like. Point. It's Weglars. Dotted the check from Stoddard. Puck along the boards. Hep just got to clear it, and he will. Stoddard at the red line will poke it ahead. St. Paul's had some tired guys out there again. New Hampton has been the better team trying to chip away at that 5-goal lead. We've seen comebacks before. There's a shot and another save by Cal Welch. He's had to make a lot here in the third and is looking quite strong between the pipes, might I say. This one stuffed at the left post. Actually, it's behind the net. No, net is off its moorings again. That's what the whole deal is. They've been coming off a lot. I think I've mentioned that. 10:37 left to play here in this period, and the computer is dead, so the live stream is over. So, if you missed us on the live stream, if you're coming back to watch the last 10 minutes because you couldn't catch it on the live stream, there's 10 minutes and 20 seconds left to the play, and it's 8-3 St. Paul's, icing against the Big Red here. Quite a hockey game here at the Jake, as they call it. New Hampton shots here in the third. They have 11 at this point, so Cal Welch has made 11 saves. He's keeping St. Paul's in that padded lead they have right now, as New Hampton's been pouring it on here in the third. But Welch has been a wall. A little alliteration of W's. The Welch wall. Bryce Terry at center, dug away. Here's Malcolm Bussey with some space. Bussey a shot, and it was stopped by Bryan. He hasn't seen a puck in a few minutes. Rebounds over on that left wall. This line will go to work of Bussey, Grady, and Terry. All names ending in Y. This is what happens in 5-goal games, I guess. Not that this one's not interesting. But believe me, it is. Oh! Yee was hammered in behind the goal there. That was David Hellady, who laid a check, then Christian Yee going off rather gingerly. I feel like I've been using that phrase a lot tonight, way more than my liking. That hit caught Yee up high. Now, Christian is not a big kid. That's not a knock on him whatsoever. He's a freshman, right? Cal Welch takes a tap from Bryce Terry off the faceoff. St. Paul's controls the puck. It's Frechette. He's bumped in there by Gavin Brandon. Puck works its way up the near wall. Bryce Terry out of the middle. Cooper Flinton across the red line. He tips it at the blue. Goes in working for it. It was turned around there by Nowitzki. Back out at center ice. It'll end up back on the stick of Nowitzki again. He'll lead the attack. Flips it up to the opposing blue line. Mick Frechette. Nowitzki again, taking a bump in front of us. Halliday was on him. Josh. Both JT and Colin Richard are sidelined. A turnover. Here's Josh Halliday working into the back end. He finds Flinton. And Flinton shoots, but going down. And getting a leg. I believe it Kent Hill last year. Joe did. After this game, the girls' teams will play. The shot off the faceoff by Halliday. He's looking for that hat trick. He has only two tonight. I didn't mean to throw the only in there. It just kind of came out. Only two. Nearly turned over. It is turned over, but Halliday, I think he had a little bit more time than he thought he did. After this, the St. Paul's and New Hampton girls varsity hockey teams will meet. A 6 p.m. Friday game. The night tilts. Here comes Matthew Babineau. Thrusting his way into the zone. Hep lays a hit in behind the goal. Another check on the near wall laid by Josh. At the bottom of the faceoff circle, the pack goes to the far side. Seibold, Jack Hep turning away. Nice little spinorama in tight spaces. He's now knocked down, but Stadheim comes in to help out. It's loose there. Good work by Babineau in low. Puck still battled on behind the St. Paul's net, and it's Owen Stadheim who ends up pulling it away and lofting at the center. Petcher. Daniel Petcher off the wall. His brother Merrick, a forward. Daniel, a defender. Merrick, if you can remember, all the way back to the first 8 seconds of the first period. Yeah, the first goal of the game. Part of a blazing hot start by New Hampton. I wouldn't say it fizzled out, but it was overcome by the Red Wave. They are offside there. Castino did all he could. But he is the guy just a step ahead at the line. Do you recall the long ago when you walked on the floor? off the faceoff in neutral territory from that offside. Jake Sullivan. Quick feet here by Castino. He's onside this time with some help. The shot came off the wall. Tell you what, the difference between the pressure by New Hampton right now, if we had a stoppage in play, Evan Moore's helmet is off. The difference between right now is New Hampton pressure, which is, it's heavy, right? They're pouring on pressure, but it's not like what we saw in the first period. The first period, New Hampton was in the middle of the ice. They were pursuing those pucks in the middle of the rink, and they were getting to pucks in the middle of the rink and getting them in the back of the net. St. Paul's have been keeping New Hampton to the outside for the most part here in the third, and they've whittled away most of the period thus far as that puck just went up and hit my dad in the face. And by my dad, I mean Coach Dan Murphy. That got him up near the eye. And he has stepped off the bench. Longtime viewers know, of course, that my dad is the coach. I don't really refer to him. I try to be honest with the viewers, you know. You got to name your biases, if you will. So he's got an ice pack to his eye right now. I think he's going to be okay. I'm giggling only because he's my dad. It's not that I'm not concerned. I am. And I hope he's all right. It's just been that kind of night. And St. Paul's ahead here. So it's not a night where in which everything has gone wrong. It's just a night where everything's just been weird. They're working in here. Stoddard the shot. And it just goes wide of the goal. Might have got a block on it. Bounced out to center. Here's Alex Lobdell, the Bedford native, across center. He's going from near to far, horizontally across the ice. Bounced as he came into the zone with Joe Gillette. He's stripped of the puck eventually. I'll let you know when my dad pops back onto the bench. And now he's behind, holding the ice pack to his right eye. And he's going to go back on the bench, holding the ice pack to his right eye, I think. Well, we've seen players go off the ice, nursing some injuries. They've all been all right. Now it's the coach nursing an injury. St. Paul's leading the game 8-3, and maybe that'll make all the wounds feel a bit better. These two teams I mentioned, they'll play tomorrow night at Gordon Rink in Concord, a home of the St. Paul School Big Red. That's a 5 o'clock start, and it will be live on Hockey Night in Concord, so hope you can join us. We're not live right now, of course. I'll be more prepared next time, I do promise. Maybe I'll bring... Hold on a minute, here's Bryce Terry going quickly. Pucks at the front of the net, getting through there with Bussey, and he's stopped short of the goal line by the goaltender, Lucas Brine. Under 5 minutes to play here. And Bryce Terry just took a stick in the gut, and he's down on the ice. That was quite obvious. He had the stick knocked out of his hands, and he took a stick right in the neck underneath his cage. Talk about letting them play. I don't know how they didn't catch that one. I will say, for what the referees have and haven't called, I'm not one to say, but they have been hands off. And they haven't been exactly active, shall we say. Puck to the front here and lying out in front of the goal is Sullivan. Cooper Flinton the other way with blazing speed. The Dartmouth commit into the zone. Sending the puck off the back of the net. He was Gordon Will to the outside there by Daniel Petcher. Now a bouncing puck through. Flinton standing in front of the goal. Couldn't get a stick on that one. Then behind the New Hampton net now. Flinton is battling away. New Hampton wins the puck free. Daniel Petcher again. Halliday, he got over there and hit Zach Goodhart. That'll get aroused. Yeah, the St. Paul's bench, Flinton on the wall now. He's dangerous. Flinton still moving. His shot, he just beamed it wide on the far side. Sullivan steps up at the line. He'll throw it back in deep. It's behind the New Hampton net right now. Daniel Petcher moving it up to the far wall. Seibold had a stick on him. Petcher still carrying. Hits the red line, tosses it right into the glove of Cal Welch. Seibold through neutral ice, and they were stopped at the line. 3 minutes and 20 seconds left of the game, folks. Thanks for joining us. It has been a ride. That puck getting away from everybody, and now it's stolen off the stick of Yee. In they come, and drawing the penalty is Townsend. The puck was just bouncing around on him. And they're going to call a shot. That's right, that's the one thing we've been missing from this game. Somehow Townsend is nursing a shoulder. Owen Stadheim also ended up on his back end. I don't know what happened there. Now the rules are that they can pick anyone to take the shot. And Connor Gorman is going to put the onus on Nick Townsend. He's a sophomore from Wakefield, Massachusetts. He played at St. John's Prep last year, and he will go against Cal Welch. With 3 minutes left in the game in an 8-3 game. The one thing we have been missing. There we go. Townsend from the faceoff circle at center. Across the blue line, tops of the circle, shoots, and it's stopped by Welch. He moved into just about the hash marks before he took the shot. And tried to go blocker side, but Cal got in front of that. And we'll play with 3 minutes left to go. Still an 8-3 score. We've had it all here. Fitzfrischette nearly got that puck in behind Reglars, who was felled at center. Tracking with it, Lobdell. He turned it over at the Husky logo. It's there in neutral territory. Now it trickles through. Weglars again up the left side, just getting out of the way of that hit by Yee was Hellady. And now Hellady will push further. It's getting physical. Hellady moving right on in, and he's dumped by Mick. Just before he made it to the goal. And now Mick fends off a check. St. Paul's will get it out. Could be a 2-on-1. It is a 2-on-1. Seibold for Frechette. Fitzfrischette in front. Oh, and coming through at the last moment was Stadheim. And he just couldn't find the goal. 2 minutes left in the game. Russell misses Fitzfrischette now, and this will be an icing call. Puck out of play off the draw. Frechette got in front of it. The shot by Daniel Petcher. Trevor Castino against, who was that? I think that might have been Doherty in the faceoff circle. Doherty, Biggs, and Stoddard out up front for St. Paul's. Biggs felled his man. The St. Paul's bench was out of it early when the team was out of it. They've been into it since the team has been on top. And a turnover here in the middle. Doherty moving, shooting. He ripped it high. Back off the boards. Biggs trying to pot one. He'd be the third freshman to pot one in this game if he were to. As Josh Howdy and Ryan Doherty have goals. And not that many freshmen on the roster. I think there's only five of them? Four of them? Four of them. I have that info on hand. We'll see. Sent into the zone here by St. Paul's. Quite a night here at the Jake. And St. Paul's looks like they're going to get their first ever regulation win against New Hampton. They've never beat them in the four regulation games they've played over the last two seasons. They're up by five with a minute to go. In comes Jake Terra. Of course, they'll play again tomorrow night. Cal Welch firing another shot away with the shoulder. It's bounced out. Malcolm Bussey's going to give it a goal. He's up the right side, moving in on goal. He just missed wide. He had Brian beat too, and just couldn't thread it past the post. He's looked good in the early going, Bussey has. Team about to pick up its third win of the season as Brian covers up. We get a stoppage with 35 seconds left to play. It was a five-goal avalanche. That's the word. Five-goal avalanche in the second by St. Paul's. Eight straight. And you know what? I got to give props to Cal Welch, too. He has faced a lot of pucks here in the third. 13 or 14. And he has held the fort strong as well. So a good performance after a shaky start here for St. Paul's. Another puck out of play. And for those of you who joined the live stream, I'm sorry about it cutting out with about 10 minutes left to go. Won't happen again tomorrow night. It's a learning process. The first year I've done this, first game I've done this on the road. There's no outlets here. If there was an outlet, I obviously would have plugged the computer in. Out of his net to stop this puck is Welch. Ooh, going in hard in behind the play is Terra. It's sent through to the front of the net. Picked up here by Weglar as a drive. And another save by Cal Welch. It'll be led out of the zone by Dylan Biggs. He gets it across the red line. 3 seconds and then two. 2 seconds and then one. The Big Red win it. An 8-3 victory over New Hampton after going down 8 seconds into the game. After going down 3-0 early in the first. They take the win back home to Concord. 8-3 your final here from New Hampton. They'll meet again tomorrow night in Concord. And I certainly hope you can join. The teams will salute each other at center ice. And we'll be back again tomorrow night, 5 o'clock puck drop. But so far here from New Hampton, a wild one between the Huskies and the Big Red. And St. Paul's takes the win 8-3, your final score. We'll see you tomorrow. Enjoy the rest of your evening.